Yeah. I mean, it's interesting because I will talk to other filmmakers or, and who are really wanting to get out of just being seen as like people with cameras, like video production crew, and the storytelling, the pre-production, the vision, the outlines, you know, someone's going to take the lead on that. And if it's not us, the client will. And right. That doesn't necessarily mean it's a bad thing. It's just, I think a lot of people have the desire to you know, to create something from start to finish. But ultimately, we have to know why we're making it ahead of time and spend the time up front before we just show up with cameras.
Yeah, and especially now, that's what's need more than I need someone who knows how to make a video. People need that bigger holistic approach. I need people who know how to tell a story. And I know people who know how to like understand me and my story and my organization and how to tell it in a way that's going to be compelling to my audience. Because it used to be that if you just had enough money as a filmmaker and you could invest in the gear and the software, you could do it. You could make videos. That was kind of the barrier for a long time. And then
just selling that, like, you need video.
You need
Here's
video.
Why.
Yeah. And it was just very templated, very like, here it is. And that is long gone, because anybody with even a couple $100 or an iPhone can make really nice looking, high quality images.
Yeah.
And so it's not about that anymore. It's about the separator is not the ability and the access. It's now the craftsmanship, the artistry, the creativity, what makes you unique. Can you tell a story? Can you enter into an empathetic place with your client to like understand what they really need? That's the difference, and that's what story acceleration really
brings.
Yeah, and
it's engagement. Like, I mean, I'm just so sick of watching corporate videos that as soon as I hear that exact like music, it's like the same
delay guitar.
The same, yeah.
That's what I'm trying to emulate.
It's like they use the same, I don't know, program or instrument or whatever. You hear that exact, like, yeah, the
Audio Jungle. When they don't take it out, they don't purchase the song.
Or I like it when they use the stock loops that are in like iMovie.
Yeah.
You know,
even better.
Da-da-da. There's like one that I hear all the time. It's just royalty free and they just slap it in there.
We can make fun of it because we've done it.
Yeah.